Tea, Coffee, Murder, Episode 1, The Art of Lying. Written by Ellen Barksdale. Narrated by Jessica Whittaker. Prologue. In which Cecily Beresford is deprived of sleep at her home in Earlsraven. What? It was the fourth night in a row that Cecily Beresford had been startled from her sleep by a whispering voice. She sat bolt upright in bed and looked out into the dark night, keeping one hand pressed to her chest to steady her rapidly beating heart. The same voice. Again and again. Why did it say such things to her? Why couldn't it leave her alone? The answer was quite simple. It was because she was right. And she knew that a wrong had been committed. What she didn't know was how to prove it. It was hopeless. And that was what was keeping her awake at night. Not because justice should prevail, but because someone wanted to mock her. Cecily Beresford flipped the flannel blanket aside and sat on the edge of the bed, then took a few breaths before standing up. The old bed creaked with every movement, as it had done in her grandmother Eugenie's time. And like her ancestor, Cecily had long since ceased to notice the noises made by the solid wooden frame or the springs. March had been sunny, but the sun was weak and the nights were chilly, so her fluffy blanket was a must. Cecily reached for the bathrobe that lay on the chair right next to the bed, put it on and left the bedroom. She walked down the short hallway, the beam of her mobile phone aimed at the floor. For a woman in her mid-80s, she was still nimble on her feet and in her mind, but she was also careful not to get overconfident. At her age, one wrong step could mean the next few weeks in hospital, or worse. She'd had great foresight years ago to turn her former study on the ground floor into a bedroom, so she didn't have to use the stairs every day if she didn't want to. In the living room, she stopped in front of the old sideboard. Her gaze was drawn to the wall above it. She shook her head and whispered anxiously, "That's not it. That's not it." Cecily returned to the bedroom and lay back down. Given how she was feeling, she knew she wouldn't be able to fall asleep anytime soon, much like the past three nights. How long was this going to go on? She lowered her head to the pillow and closed her eyes. Eventually, sleep would get the better of her. "I'm right," she muttered. "Someday." Chapter 1. In which Nathalie unexpectedly receives a letter that turns her life upside down. Liverpool. A few days after Cecily's sleepless night in Earlsraven.
"Mr. Kresnick, I regret to inform you that your brother has been killed," the inspector said with a solemn expression.
"Stuart? Are you talking about Stuart?"
asked Kresnick, looking startled. "He's my only brother."
"I'm sorry, Mr. Kresnick."
"What's happened?"
Kresnick's wife came to the door and looked back and forth in horror between her husband and the police officer.
"The inspector has come to tell me that my brother is dead,"
Kresnick declared in a tone denoting something that did not concern him at all.
"Stuart? Is he talking about Stuart?"
she wanted to know. Kresnick nodded.
"He was your only brother."
"That's what I told the inspector,"
her husband replied. Mrs. Kresnick turned to the policeman.
"Stuart was his only brother, you must know."
The inspector nodded.
"Your husband mentioned it, Mrs."
"Oh, I've had enough of this," Nathalie groaned, turning off the television. "If they keep talking this kind of nonsense, the killer will die."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.